78-year-old Muzeya's Koferi Kizza Katongole lives in retirement in the village of Chitegula in Kasawo town, Kayunga district. This is the man behind the design of St. Peter's Church in Ndeeba, which now lies in ruins. A disappointed Katongole narrates how the decision to start a new church came as a result of disagreements between members of a church in Katwe in 1976.
I mean, people were gathering in a small makeshift of papyruses and whatever. It was a nursery school of the late lady called Kagumia Nkoyoyo, who was the sister, the elder sister of the late Archbishop Mpalanyi Nkoyoyo.
2 years later, in 1978, the plan to construct a permanent church began to take shape.
We went to find out from the KCC whether that land was theirs so that we could buy it and construct a church. Then those people denied that that land was not theirs. So we went ahead to look for who is the owner.
The search for the land owner started, and their investigations from the land's office led them to one Princess Evelyn Nachwa, a daughter to the former Kabaka of Buganda, Daudi Chwa.
We went to her, we negotiated. She gave us that land free of charge to construct a church. And in fact, she instructed us not to do any other business on that land.
However, they were advised to legalize the grant from the princess.
The princess gave us her daughter who was working in the Ministry of Education. That daughter helped us to accomplish or to do all the job of transferring and owning the land, demarcating, land surveying and whatever. So we did all the work and we acquired the title. I think it was in 1979, late.
Katongole, a trained building designer, was chosen to be on the building commission and was also asked to draw a plan for the church.
It was me who designed the shape of that church. I mean, if you look at it, it is Jesus Christ standing on the planet Earth, giving us grace.
The turmoil that accompanied the overthrow of President Idi Amin interrupted the construction works. After peace was restored, unfortunately, Katongole left the area in 1990, only to return in the early 2000s when the church had been completed.
I went there, visited the place, and saw the, and I prayed, because the church which I designed myself has been constructed.
In 2012, a reunion party was organized for the founders of the church, and Katongole was given the certificate of appreciation. On the same occasion, foreign guests offered to construct a school for the church, and this is when they learned of people claiming ownership of the land. President Museveni shone a ray of hope when he promised that the church would be rebuilt. However, Katongole is skeptical.
President has got a lot of promises he has done so far to many things, to many places, to many people. But most of these pledges and whatever are not done to date.
Currently, there is a makeshift church which has been put up for Christians to tentatively worship in when churches are allowed to reopen. To Katongole, this brings back memories of how they started over 4 decades ago. Solomon Kawesa, NTV.